Hey guys, Corey here. Getting ready to start on a carpet out here in Kyle, Texas right now. Everything is upstairs. I'm thinking there's, we'll go up there and take a look in a second. I'm thinking I counted three, maybe four rooms, the hall and stairs. There's a master closet downstairs that has carpet in it, but it doesn't have a pad under the carpet. At least half of it doesn't. So I'm assuming they're gonna want something done with that. They just don't know about it yet, and I don't have enough pad to put under it to even bring to their attention. So we're gonna be in a carpet cleaning mission here. It is, it could be torn out. It wouldn't be a bad idea. The house is in not great shape. It's been lived in kind of rough, so the carpet's kind of in bad shape. So this will be one of the ones that I hit really, really, really hard with the pre-spray, mainly because it's in the shape that it's in and I'm here by myself. Lately, I've been doing a lot of repairs for one, and for two, there's been a lot of families around while I'm cleaning. So it makes it difficult for me to run a camera and explain to you guys what I'm doing, as well as converse with the people that, you know, they're there in the house. I always make time to converse with the people that I'm working for to get to know them. So anyway, let's take a look around down here on the first floor, and then we'll go upstairs and look around. I feel like it'll clean up good. It's just gonna take more than the average carpet. Anyway, let's have a quick look. All right, let's just take a look here basically at the house. Looks like the maids have not been here yet, so we're basically kind of dirty everywhere. The poor garage is in kind of ugly shape. I wasn't asked to clean the garage, so I'm not gonna mess with that. Anyway, and for anybody that doesn't know, Kyle and Buda are headed towards San Antonio. When you leave Austin, the next two towns are Buda and then Kyle. And beyond that, you go to San Marcos, New Braunfels, and then you get to San Antonio. So this is South Austin. Well, not really Austin, it's Hayes County. Kind of the same, only a little different. This room here looks like it wasn't lived in angrily. So this, I think, is the best shape of any carpet. It looks like it's not, maybe not that old. There's no vacuuming done. These two rooms here are, see a little red there. I'm gonna treat that when I'm pre-spraying, treat that with ammonia, straight ammonia on that one. And knock that little bit of red out. The first thing is going to be to vacuum like crazy, but I should get this back looking good again. And there is another little room over here, which is just awful, I guess. I've just been doing different stuff lately. I haven't encountered anything that's just got all gross in a couple of weeks. So this doesn't come close to the one I did a couple of weeks ago and put up. The one I did a couple of weeks ago when I put it up, I sold, I think, three Challengers because of that video I put up. Anyway, I'm gonna do all the vacuuming right quick and come back and we'll start the video on cleaning. For you new guys that are following the channel, I do my vacuuming with a Royal heavy duty commercial. I think it puts out 158 CFM. It's direct, so you know it's got a bag on it, which I prefer. You take the bag off and you throw it away, and then you're back clean again. Whereas the bagless type of vacuums, you got to take them all apart, beat the filters to death, and wear all that dust and snort it up your nose. And this is just a more powerful method of vacuuming, and it's a lot less for the user to mess with. Now, a long time ago, I've mentioned this in several videos, but in the very, very, very beginning, when I first started cleaning with Challenger in 2006, like I said, we didn't have anything local I could clean with. So this is what I made my cleaner out of. I cleaned with these two products together in water in varying potencies, and it worked great. So that's what I'm doing today. I'm doing this guy, and ammonia mixed together, fairly strong. So due to the ammonia, you're gonna have issues, you know, breathing. If you're really, you know, if you're real sensitive like that, you're gonna have issues breathing. This stuff here, it smells absolutely great. It smells just like you peeled an orange. So people love the smell of that stuff. And it's got the terpenes in it. So it's a solvent and it's got a pH to it. So it does incredibly well on just about everything. I try not to use it that much on tile because I try to make, when I clean tile, I try to make it all pH and no solvent, because when you put a solvent on tile, you run the issues of leaving a light film on the tile that will footprint up, and that's not what you want. So, because it'll look great, and then the first few footprints across it will stay, and I'll just collect it from that one on. Anyway, I'm gonna shut up here and get some vacuuming done. This guy here, this is a Dirt Devil, but it is made by Royal, same company that makes this vacuum here. So everything's the same. It's a direct drive. It spins, so it does really good on stairs. A lot of times I'll use this guy on stairs. This guy gets used on upholstery quite a bit. You can see the down feather in it right there. All right, I'm gonna shut up and I'll be back here in a bit. All right, guys, I got everything vacuumed up here and getting ready to start the cleaning. I just got this this really heartwarming text from a client that it was long, so you know I'm not gonna, you know, read it on here or anything, but for the people that are members of the VLM Carpet Cleaners Lounge that haven't been thrown out of it, that haven't been thrown out of there for being rude, can read it. A lady, it's just a client that's been of mine since probably 2013 or 2014, somewhere in there. Her mother passed away early this year, and I you know, I worked for her mother as well, Pearl family. And she sent me this heartwarming story about a guy that was really kind to an elderly woman. And she said, "This reminds me of you, because you were so nice to my mother." So anyway, I'm trying to recover from that right now. That's good stuff. It's one of those things that you know, that money doesn't, you can't buy that with money, the feeling that you get when people are really moved by what you've done. Anyway, I'm gonna start in this room first. All right, guys, I'm gonna do this one here in real time. This one's not as bad as the other ones, but it's wide open, where I can kind of show what's going on a lot easier. The other ones, I'll do my best, the really dirty ones. Anyway, we're gonna start here. This is, like I said, not that bad, but the only thing that's wide open enough to show.
6-inch glider today. And the Challenger bonnet. Just got time to order some new bonnets. These have seen lots of miles. Here, the closet first. Let's look at this a little closer while I'm cleaning here. If I can, let me shorten up this a little bit. a lot of varying opinions on how carpet is supposed to be cleaned and what you're supposed to clean it with and procedure of how to do it and everything under the sun you'll find on YouTube. As far as the way I clean carpet, when people ask you, you know, if they haven't read reviews and, you know, they don't know anything about cleaning carpet and they ask you, how do you clean carpet? It's important that you answer the question. But, you know, when you go to explain all these things, all the different ways and how you do it, people get lost in all of that. So I basically explain it in a very, very simple way. You know, how do I clean carpet? I clean carpet like I'm paying for it myself. Not like I'm cleaning for myself, or not like I'm cleaning for my mother. I clean carpet like I'm paying for it myself. Because, you know, if you're cleaning your own carpet yourself, you'll accept less, you know, because it's your own carpet and, you know, who's gonna throw a fit but yourself. So that's why I say I clean carpet like I'm paying for it, because if you're not happy with what I did, I will not accept your money. So something like that carries weight with people. So if you don't get into a long drawn out story about how you clean carpet and all these things that don't mean anything to people, they don't understand, it carries more weight. Clean carpet like you're paying for it, because if they're not happy, you shouldn't charge them anyway. It's just that simple. I've had, you know, I get it clean, you get it free as a slogan since the very beginning. So I just wanted to add that, how to clean carpet. Clean carpet like you're paying for it, because if the client doesn't like what I did and the carpet doesn't look good, I'm not gonna accept their money. All right, now some hallway here. some groove in here. Looks like this one's gonna look just about perfect when I get done. Vacuumed up candy wrappers and everything else in the other room, in one of these rooms over here. All right, we're gonna have to do some time lapse on the other ones, or just before and afters or something. I've only got 23 minutes invested in just this one clip here. But turned out really well. All right, now what we're dealing with over here. We will do a before and after on this one here. This is gonna be the next one I clean here. So get a look at it now, and we'll have a look when I get done. All right. I did that one room here, and this was considerably more difficult than I thought it would be. Some of the black marks took direct ammonia to make them budge. They would not move. A little bit of the red would not come out, and that is a furniture dye stain right there. That is a patcher. We're not patching, but that's a patcher. There. All right, now I re-upped the pre-spray here, changed it, made it a little bit stronger just for the people that enjoy that, watch the channel. It's so damn strong now, you wouldn't even, couldn't believe it. All right. Now, gonna do a before and after on this room. Hallway. And then, let's show a little clean here. Anyway, boy, this ought to come clean really, really easy after what all I've done in my pre-spray. Anyway, I'll be back when I get done with that room. All right, last room here to be done. Let's take a look here at what I've just done here. We're gonna do this last room here in time lapse. Let me look at it a little. There we go. Let me see more like that. All right, we're gonna set up over here and we're gonna do this guy here in time lapse so we can see some cleaning and not take forever. There's not really much going on in here. This is just a sand and shoot, basically. Spray it and clean it, and it shouldn't be any real issues. Nothing in here to cause much issue. All right. We are basically done with the video here. I'm gonna do the stairs. I'm not gonna cover the stairs. It's not gonna be a good video covering the stairs. At any rate, glad I finally got a really good house here where I could shoot a good video here and get all crunk with my pre-spray like I like to be. This ought to be completely dry. Yeah, dry, 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 dry. Super dry. I can, on the videos, it looks like I'm putting out a ton of pre-spray, but yet I get quick dry times. That's how I can prevent any wicking. All right, I'm gonna bring up the work here. I'm probably gonna get in here just a little bit more with the orc when I get started, just for my sake of cleaning here. I want to, like right there, you can see through a camera a little bit, but you can't really see it otherwise. But I'm gonna mess around with that a little before I do the stairs. Anyway, all right, guys, that basically does it for the video here. I'm gonna finish off the stairs and go and upload this video. Anyway, my eyes are stinging a little bit now because I really upped it like crazy in that room over there with the ammonia. All right, if you have questions, you're welcome to put them in the comments. And if you're interested in purchasing a Challenger, the sale is over now, but my $100 rebate remains. Anybody that buys a Challenger through me, you get your questions answered, you know, by somebody that's in the business that does cleaning, not just some salesperson. So you're welcome to text me with your questions. If you buy a Challenger, and you get $100 off. I'll tell you $100 thank you for purchasing a machine through me, because I'm not a salesman, I'm a carpet guy. I'm a carpet guy that believes a lot in the equipment that I clean with, and I'm here just showing it to you guys
So if you're interested, you know, you're more than welcome to text, and I can get the ball rolling on getting you a machine, and it comes with financing. You can finance it as well if you like. All right, that does it for this one. Thanks for watching, guys. God bless. See you on the next one.